The subject of the atom and atomic nucleus. Lecture number 18, theme, fission of atomic nuclei. The secondary neutrons emitted during nuclear fission can cause new fission events, which makes it possible to implement a fission chain reaction. A chain reaction of fission is a nuclear reaction in which the particles causing the reaction are formed as products of this reaction. The chain fission reaction is characterized by the coefficient of multiplication k of neutrons, which is equal to the ratio of the number of neutrons in a given generation to their number in the previous generation. A necessary condition for the development of chain fission reaction is the requirement k greater and or equals 1. Not all secondary neutrons produce subsequent fission of nuclei, which leads to a decrease in the multiplication constant. First, because of the finite dimensions of reactor core, the space where the chain reaction occurs, and the large penetrating power of neutrons, some of them will leave the reactor core before it is captured by any nucleus. Secondly, some of the neutrons are captured by the nuclei of non-fissionable impurities, which are always present in reactor core. Third, along with fission, competing processes of radiation capture and inelastic scattering can take place. The multiplication constant depends on the nature of the fissile material, on the amount of the isotope, on the size and shape of the reactor core. The minimum dimensions of the reactor core at which a chain reaction is possible are called critical dimensions. The minimum mass of the fissile material in the system of critical dimensions, which is necessary for the realization of chain reaction, is called the critical mass. The rate of development of chain reactions is different. Let T is the average lifetime of the one generation, and N is the number of neutrons in a given generation. In the next generation, their number is K multiplied N. It has an increase in the number of neutrons per generation. Dn equals Kn multiplied N minus N equals N multiplied open bracket K minus 1 closed bracket. Increase the same number of the neutrons per unit time, it has the rate of chain reaction increase is equal. Dn over dt equals n multiplied open bracket k minus 1 closed bracket divided t. Integrating, we obtain n equals n 0 multiplied e open bracket k minus 1 multiplied t divided t power, where N0 is the number of the neutrons at the zero time, and N is their number at time t. N is determined by the sign k minus 1. For k greater than 1, there is a developing reaction. The number of the fissions continuously increases, and the reaction can become explosive. For k equals 1, a self-sustaining reaction takes place, in which the number of the neutrons does not change with time. For k less than 1, a damped reaction proceeds. Chain reactions are divided into controlled and non-controlled. The explosion of an atomic bomb, for example, is an uncontrolled reaction. In order that the atomic bomb does not explode during storage, 238 uranium or 239 plutonium is divided into parts separated from each other with mass below the critical ones. Then, with the help of the conventional explosion, this mass approaches each other, the total mass of the material becomes more critical, and the explosive chain reaction occurs, accompanied by the instantaneous release of a fast amount of energy and large disruptions. The explosive reaction starts from the available neutrons of spontaneous fission or neutrons from cosmic radiation. Controlled chain reactions are carried out in nuclear reactors. In nature, there are three isotopes that can serve as nuclear fuel. 235th uranium. In natural uranium, it contains about 0.7%. Or raw materials for its production, 232nd thorium and 238th uranium. In natural uranium, it contains about 99.3%. 232nd thorium serves as a starting product for the production of artificial nuclear fuel, 233 uranium. And 238 uranium nucleus absorbs neutrons through two successive beta minus decays, transforms to nucleus 239 plutonium. Next reaction. The implementation of control chain reaction of fission becomes a great importance in nuclear power. Devices in which the controlled chain reaction of fission is carried out and maintained are called nuclear reactors. The first reactor in the world was launched at the University of Chicago, 1942, under the leadership of Enrico Fermi. In Russia and in Europe, in Moscow, 1946, under the leadership of Khrushchev. Consider the principle of the reactor of thermal neutrons. See figure. In the reactor core, there are fuel elements 1 and the moderator 2, in which neutrons are slowed to thermal velocities. The fuel elements 12 are blocks of fission material enclosed in a hermetic shell, which weakly absorbs neutrons. Due to the energy released during nuclear fission, 12 are heated, and therefore they are placed in the coolant flow for cooling. 3 channel for the coolant flow. The reactor core is surrounded by reflector 4, which reduces neutron escape. Control of the chain reaction is carried out by special control rods 5 from materials that strongly absorb neutrons, for example, boron and cadmium. The parameters of the reactor are calculated so that when the rods are completely inserted, the reaction does not proceed. When the rods are gradually removed, the neutron multiplication constant increases and at some position assumes a value of 1. At this point, the reactor starts to work. As it operates, the amount of fission material in the reactor core decreases and fission fragments occur, among which there may be strong neutron absorbers. In order for the reaction not to cease, control and often special compensating rods are gradually extracted from the reactor core by means of the automatic device. Such control of the reaction is possible due to the existence of delayed neutrons emitted by fissionable nuclei with a delay of up to 1 minute. After the burning of nuclear fuel, the reaction ceases. Prior to the new launch of the reactor, the burned nuclear fuel is extracted and loaded new. In the reactor, there are also safety rods, which are introduced when the intensity of the reaction is suddenly increased and the reaction ceases immediately. The nuclear reactor is a powerful source of the penetrating radiation, neutrons, gamma radiation, approximately 10 to 11 power times higher than sanitary standards. Therefore, any reactor has a biological shielding, a system of screens or protective materials, for example, concrete, lead, water, located behind its reflector and remote control. Nuclear reactors differ. First, by the nature of the main materials in the reactor core, nuclear fuel, moderator, heat transfer. As fission and raw materials used 235th uranium, 239th plutonium, 3 uranium, 238 uranium, 232nd thorium. As moderators, water, ordinary and heavy, graphite, beryllium, organic liquids, etc. As coolants, air, water, water vapor, helium, carbon dioxide, and etc. Second, by the nature of the placement of nuclear fuel and the moderator in the reactor core, homogeneous, both substances are evenly mixed with each other, and heterogeneous, both substances are arranged separately as blocks. Third, on the neutron energy, reactors on thermal and fast neutrons. In the latter, neutron fission is used and there is no moderator at all. Fourth, by mode, continuous and pulsed. Fifth, by designation, energy research reactors for the production of new fission materials, radioactive isotopes, etc. In accordance with the characteristics considered, names such as uranium graphite, water water, graphite gas reactors, etc. Among nuclear reactors, special place is occupied by power reactor breeders. In them, along with the generation of electricity, the process of reproducing nuclear fuel as a result of the reaction is proceeding. This means that in a reactor with natural or slightly enriched uranium, not only the isotope 235th, but also the isotope 238th uranium is used. At present, fast neutron reactors are the basis of the nuclear power with the reproduction of fuel. For the first time, nuclear energy for peaceful purposes was used in the USSR. In Obninsk, 1954, under the leadership of Khrushchev, the first nuclear power plant with a capacity of 5 MW put into operation. The operating principle of the nuclear power plant of water-water reactor is shown in figure. Uranium blocks 1 are immersed in water 2, which serves both as a moderator and as a heat transfer. Hot water in a under pressure and then heated up to 300 Celsius degree from the upper part of the reactor core enters through the pipeline 3 into the steam generator 4, where it's evaporated and cools, and then returns through the pipeline 5 to the reactor. Saturated vapor 6 through the pipeline 7 enters to the steam turbine 8, returning after working through the pipeline 9 into the steam generator. The turbine rotates the electric generator 10. The current from which enters the removal cross section. In the CIS, in addition to building powerful nuclear power plants, for example, Novovoronezhskaya atom power station with a total capacity of about 1,500 MW, the first stage of the Leningradskaya APS with 2,000 MW reactors. Much attention has been paid to the development of small nuclear power plants with 750 to 1,500 kilowatt, convenient for operation of specific conditions small nuclear power. For example, the world's first mobile nuclear power plants were built. The world's first reactor, Ramashka, was created, in which semiconductors directly convert thermal energy to electric. There are 49 kilogram 235th uranium in the reactor core. The thermal power of the reactor is 40 kilowatt. The electric power is 0.8 kilowatt. Huge opportunities for the development of nuclear energy are opened with the creation of breeder reactors, or the fast neutrons, breeders, in which the generation of energy is accompanied by the production of secondary fuel, plutonium, which will radically solve the problem of providing nuclear fuel. Estimates show that 1 ton of granite contains about 3 grams, 238 uraniums, and 12 grams, 232 thorium. They are used as raw materials in breeder reactors. At the energy consumptions of 5 × 10⁸ megawatt, to orders of the magnitude higher than now, the reserve of uranium and thorium in granite will last for 1 billion years. The reaction of the synthesis of atomic nuclei, the formation of the heavier nuclei from light nuclei, can be a source of vast energy. The specific building energy of nuclei sharply increases upon transition from the nuclei of heavy hydrogen, deuterium and tritium, to lithium, and especially to helium. It is the reactions of the synthesis of light nuclei into heavier nuclei should be accompanied by the release of large amount of energy. As an example, let us consider the synthesis reactions. First reaction, second, third, and fourth reactions, where Q is the energy release. In the reactions of the synthesis of atomic nuclei, the energy released by nucleon is much greater than the fission reactions in the heavy nuclei. When the nucleus of 238 uranium is fissioned, an energy of about 200 mega electron volt is released, which is about 0.84 mega electron volt per nucleon. In the synthesis reactions, this value is 17.6 divided 5 mega electron volt, approximately equals 3.5 mega electron volt. Let us estimate the temperature of the course of the reaction of fusion of deuterium nuclei. In order that to connect the deuterium nuclei, they must be brought closer to a distance of 2 × 10⁻⁵ meter, equal to the radius of action of nuclear forces, thus overcoming the potential energy of repulsion approximately equals 0.7 mega electron volt. Each colliding nucleus accounts from half of this energy. The average energy of the thermal motion equal to 0.35 mega electron volt corresponds to the temperature approximately equal to 2.6 × 10⁹ Kelvin. Consequently, the fusion reaction of deuterium nuclei can occur only at temperature of 2 or the order exceeding the temperature of the central regions of the Sun, about 1.3 × 10⁷ Kelvin. However, it turns out that the temperature of the order of 10⁷ Kelvin is sufficient for the reaction of synthesis of atomic nuclei. This is due to two factors. First, at temperatures typical for reactions of synthesis of atomic nuclei, any substance is in a state of plasma, the particle distribution of which obeys Maxwell's law. Therefore, there is always a certain number of nuclei whose energy is much higher than the mean. Second, the synthesis of nuclei can occur due to the tunneling effect. The reaction of the synthesis of light atomic nuclei into heavier ones occurring at ultra higher temperatures, about 10⁷ Kelvin and above, are called thermonuclear reactions. Thermonuclear reactions are the source of the energy of the Sun and stars. Possible ways of thermonuclear reactions on the Sun. First way, carbon-nitrogen or carbon cycle, characteristic of high temperatures, approximately 10⁻²⁰ 7th power Kelvin. Second way, proton-proton or hydrogen cycle, a characteristic of temperature approximately 10 to 7 power Kelvins. As a result of this cycle, 4 protons are converted into helium nucleus and an energy of 26.7 megaelectron volt is released. Carbon nuclei, the number of which remains unchanged, participate in the reaction as a catalyst. Thermonuclear reactions give the highest energy yield per unit mass of fuel than any other transformations, including the fission of heavy nuclei. For example, the amount of deuterium in a glass of simple water is approximately equivalent to about 60 liters of gasoline. Therefore, the prospect of implementing thermonuclear reactions by artificial means is tempting. The hydrogen cycle dominates at low temperatures. Starting with a temperature of 10 to 15 million Celsius degrees, the main reaction is next reaction. At high temperatures, reactions A, B, C with formation boron neutrino, it is registered with a chlorine argon detector. At moderate temperatures, reactions A and B. For the first time, an artificial thermonuclear reaction was carried out in the USSR 1953 and then in 6 months in the USA in the form of an explosion of a hydrogen thermonuclear bomb, which is an uncontrolled reaction. An explosive was a mixture of deuterium and tritium, and a conventional atomic bomb was used as a fuse with the explosion of which with the necessary temperature for the thermonuclear reaction take place. The implementation of the controlled thermonuclear reaction, for which is necessary to create and maintain a limited temperature of the order of 10 to 8 Kelvin, is a particular interest. Since a given temperature, a thermonuclear working substance is a completely ionized plasma. The problem arises of its effective thermal insulation from the walls of the working volume. At which stage of development is it considered that the main way in this direction is to hold of the plasma in a limited volume with strong magnetic fields and a special shape. The beginning of the broad international cooperation in the field of the high-temperature plasma physics and control of thermonuclear fusion is laid by the works of Igor Kurchatov. Under the leadership of Lev Atzimovich's team of scientists in the Institute of Atomic Energy, after name Igor Kurchatov, carried out a wide range of the studies, which resulted in the launch in the summer of 1975 in the Institute of Atomic Energy of the world's largest thermonuclear installation, Tokamak 10, T10. In T10, plasma is created a toroidal chamber located in the magnetic field, and the plasma formation itself, a plasma core, also has a form of a torus. In 10T, a plasma with a temperature of about 7 to 8 multiplied 10 to 6 Kelvin and the density of about 10 to 14 power particles per second cube is created in a volume of approximately 5 meter cube for a time of about 1 second. The Lawson criterion is a condition necessary for the initiation of the self-sustaining thermonuclear reaction. N multiplied tau greater than 20, 12 multiplied K multiplied T divide alpha function from T multiplied eta multiplied Q, where tau is the confinement time of the plasma in the hot state. N is the total concentration of the nuclear particles. Alpha function from T is a function of temperature, the form of which is determined by the energy dependence of the reaction cross-section and by the conditions of the heat exchange processes in the thermal. in the plasma. Eta is efficiency. Eta equals 1/3, Q equals 17.6 mega electron volt. The Lawson condition for the stationary progress of the ternium-tritium reaction n multiplied tau greater than 10 to 20 power. Temperature approximately equals 2 multiplied 10 to 8 power Kelvin. The Lawson condition for the deuterium-deuterium reaction n multiplied T greater than 10 to 22 power T approximately equal 10 to 9 power Kelvin. There are many methods of intense plasma heating. The most developed ohmic method, based on the fact that the plasma is a conductor, and when passing current through it, joule heat is released. Such a simple heating mechanism is only suitable for the initial stage up to approximately 10 to 9 power Kelvin, as the conductivity of the plasma increases with increasing temperature. The passage of current is also accompanied by other phenomena, the most important of which is the pinch effect. Its essence lies in the fact that due to the attraction of the individual parallel currents in the plasma, it contracts. The rapid compression is almost adiabatic and is accompanied by the release of heat. In addition, it is usually accompanied by turbulent processes and the development of shock waves, which also heat the plasma. Promising is the method of the heating the plasma by injection into a fast neutral atoms, neutrals. Such atoms freely penetrate through the confining field, get into the region of the preheating plasma and ionize in it. The fast ions held together with the plasma collide with its particles and transfer some of their energy to them. Intensive plasma radiation and injection of fast electrons are also used as methods of plasma heating. Next slide, applied literature. Next, questions to consolidate knowledge. First question, what can cause the fission chain reaction to stop? Second, compare the types of nuclear fuel for reactors. Third question, classify Kazakhstan's nuclear reactors. Fourth, which the main thermonuclear reactions are preferable for energy production? Fifth, for what reason can thermonuclear fusion occur at temperature to orders of the magnitude lower than the calculated ones? Thank you for your attention.